Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaliyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject Engineering Thermodynamics. This is Module 2, First Law of Thermodynamics, Lecture 203, Second Module, Third Lecture. We recap from the previous lecture. In the previous lecture, we studied about the steady flow energy equation and its applications to the nozzle, diffuser, turbine, compressor, pump and the heat exchanger. We derived the equation, steady flow energy equation, applicable for these devices. And here in this lecture, we solve problem using the simplified equations. And the learning outcome for the today's lecture, for this lecture, at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in steady flow energy equations. So, this is the steady flow energy equation. The equation is obtained by applying energy balance to the mechanical engineering device. The left hand side terms are energy into the system and right hand side terms are energy leaving the system. M into G Z1 plus 1 by 2 V1 square plus H1 plus Q equal to M into G Z2 plus 1 by 2 V2 square plus H2 plus W, where M is the mass flow rate through the system at inlet and the outlet. They are equal. Total, the mass entering into the system is completely leaving the system. So, this is in kilograms per second. V1, V2 are velocity at inlet and the outlet in meters per second. H1, H2, they are the specific enthalpy at inlet and the outlet in joules per kilogram. Z1, Z2, they are elevation from the datum at inlet and the outlet in meter. And Q is the heat transfer to the system or out of the system in joules per second. And W is the work done or work transfer by the system. And the units are very important here. So, we have to substitute all the terms, all the parameters in appropriate unit. That is very important for solving the problem. We take example. First example, I took all the examples from only Anna University examination question paper so that the student will get the confident after solving the problem. Example number 1, this is from Anna University question paper May 2015 and May 2016. A thermodynamic system operates under steady flow conditions. The fluid enters at 2 bar and leaves at 10 bar. The entry velocity is 30 meters per second and exit velocity is 10 meters per second. During this process, 25 megajoules per hour of heat from an external source is supplied and the increase in enthalpy is 5 megajoules per kilogram. The exit point is 20 meter above the entry point. Determine the flow work from the system if the fluid flow rate is 45 kilograms per minute. So, read the problem carefully and write down the given data. So, P1 is given as 2 bar, P2 is given as 10 bar, V1 velocity at inlet is 30 meters per second, velocity at the outlet is 10 meters per second. The amount of heat transfer Q equal to 25 megajoules per hour. So, this is heat supplied to the system, so it is positive. Enthalpy increase H2 minus H1 equal to 5 megajoules per kilogram. The exit point is 20 meter above the entry point. So, Z2 minus Z1 equal to 20 meter. And the mass flow rate is 45 kilograms per minute. And the general form of the steady flow energy equation. We repeat M into G Z1 plus V1 square by 2 plus H1 plus Q equal to M into G Z2 plus V2 square by 2 plus H2 plus W. Now, rearrange. We rearrange the term. We have to calculate the work done. So, we rearrange the term M into G Z1 minus Z2 plus V1 square minus V2 square by 2 plus H1 minus H2 plus Q. So, we want W. So, W is on the right hand side. We keep the W here and we move all the other terms to the left side. So, this is what the final equation. Now, substitute in the numerical values. M equal to 45 kilograms per minute. So, 45 divided by 60 to convert into seconds, G equal to 9.81, z1 minus z2. So z2 minus z1 equal to 20. So z1 minus z2 equal to minus 20. Velocity v1 square 30 square minus 10 square divided by 2 plus minus 5 into. So the h value change in enthalpy h2 minus h1 is given as 5 megajoules per hour. H2 minus H1 is given as 5 megajoules per kilogram. So, this is minus 5 megajoules, minus 5 in 10 power 6 plus Q value. Q value is 25 kilojoules per hour. So, megajoules per hour. So, 25 in 10 power 6 divided by 3600 to convert hour into second. So, solving the equation, complete equation, use the calculator and solve everything one by one. So, 45 by 60.75, 9.81 minus 20 minus 196.2. 30 square minus 10 square divided by 2 is 400. So, this is minus 5 in 10 power 6 plus this value is 6944.4. So, solving using the calculator, W equal to minus of 374,2902.5 joules per second or minus 3.74 megawatts. So, the answer to the problem, work from the system is minus 3.74 megawatts. So, the minus sign that indicates the work is done on the system. The example number 2, a working substance flows at a rate of 5 kilograms per second into a steady flow system at 6 bar 200 kilojoules per kilogram of internal energy and 0.4 meter cube per kg of specific volume with a velocity of 300 meters per second. It leaves at 10 bar 1600 kilojoules per kg of internal energy, 1.2 meter cube per kg of specific volume with a velocity of 150 meters per second. The inlet is 10 meters above the outlet. Work transfer to the surrounding is 3 megawatt. Evaluate the change in enthalpy. Estimate the heat transfer and it indicates the direction. This is from anionic question paper, November 2019. So, the given data, P1 is given as 6 bar, P2 is 10 bar, velocity V1 equal to 300 meters per second, velocity V2 equal to 150 meters per second, U1 internal energy at the inlet 2000 kilojoules per kilogram, internal energy at the outlet 1600 kilojoules per kilogram, specific volume of the fluid at the inlet 0.4 meter cube per kg, at the outlet V2 equal to 1.2 meter cube per kg, Z1 minus Z2, Z1 is now higher elevation 10 meter above, so Z1 minus Z2 equal to 10 meter and the work done equal to 3 megawatt, mass flow rate is 5 kilograms per second. We calculate the change in enthalpy, H1 equal to U1 plus P1 V1 equal to 2000 plus 600, P1 is given as 6 bar into 100 in kilopascal, 600 kilopascal into 0.4 equal to 2240 kilojoules per kilogram. H2 equal to U2 plus P2 V2 which is 1600 plus 1000 into 1.2 which is equal to 2800 kilojoules per kilogram and H2 minus H1 equal to 2800 minus 2240 equal to 560 kilojoules per kilogram. And the steady flow energy equation, write the equation in full form, then rearranging the term, we have to calculate here heat transfer, so Q is retained in the left hand side and all the values are taken to the right hand side. So, M into G into Z2 minus Z1 plus V2 square minus V1 square by 2 plus H2 minus H1 plus W. So, substitute in the values, M 5 kilograms per second, G is 9.81. Now, Z2 minus Z1 is minus 10, 150 square minus 300 square divided by 2 plus 560 into 1000. This is given in kilojoules per kilogram. We have to substitute in joules per kilogram. So, 560 into 1000 plus 3 into 10 power 6. So, 3 megawatt is given here. So, 3 into 10 power 6. And calculating the amount of heat transfer is 5.63 into 10 power 6 joules per kilogram. And the change in enthalpy is 560 kilojoules per kilogram. Heat transfer is 5.63 into 10 power 6 joules per second. The heat is supplied to the system. So, the heat transfer is positive. So, the heat is supplied to the system. And example number 3, the velocity and the enthalpy of a fluid at the inlet of certain nozzle are 50 meters per second and 2800 kilojoules per kilogram respectively. The enthalpy at the exit of the nozzle is 2600 kilojoules per kilogram. The nozzle is horizontal and insulated so that no heat transfer is taking place from it. Find the velocity of the fluid at the exit of the nozzle. Mass flow rate, if the nozzle area at inlet is 0.09 meter square and specific volume at the inlet of the nozzle is 1 meter cube per kilogram. And exit area of the nozzle, if the specific volume of the exit of the nozzle is 0.495 meter cube per kilogram. And after reading the problem, we write down the given data. So, velocity at the inlet is 50 meters per second. Enthalpy at the inlet is 2800 kilojoules per kilogram. Enthalpy at the outlet is 2600 kilojoules per kilogram. Area at the inlet is 0.09 meter square. Specific volume at the inlet is 1 meter cube per kilogram. Specific volume at the outlet is 0.495 meter cube per kilogram. And write down the steady flow energy equation in full form. So, the final complete equation we have to write. Then we simplify. Simplify the equation for nozzle. So, what we are given? It is adiabatic nozzle. There is no heat transfer. Q equal to 0. And there is no work done. When the fluid is flowing through the nozzle, there is no work done. W equal to 0. And so, mass is getting cancelled. And the nozzle is horizontal. It is given as nozzle is horizontal. So, Z1 equal to Z2. So, what is left out? V1 square by 2 plus H1 equal to V2 square by 2 plus H2. So, rearranging velocity at the outlet of the nozzle V2 equal to square root of V1 square plus 2000 into H2 minus H1. So, V2 equal to square root of 50 square plus 2000 into, this is in kilojoules because we have multiplied here by 1000. So, this we have to substitute H1 H2 in kilojoules per kg. So, 2800 minus 2600. So, calculating the velocity at the outlet is 634.4 meters per second. Mass flow rate of the nozzle at the inlet. So, M equal to from the continuity equation A1 V1 by small v1. So, area at the inlet is 0.09. Velocity at the inlet is 50 meters per second. And specific volume at the inlet is 1 meter cube per kilogram. So, 4.5 kilograms per second. And the area at the exit of the nozzle, so the same equation from the continuity equation M equal to A2 V2 by small v2. Now, A2 area at the exit equal to M into small v2 divided by capital V2, velocity, specific volume. So, 4.5 into 0.495 divided by 634.4 equal to 3.5 into 10 power minus 3 meter square. So, the answer to the problem, exit velocity is 434.4 meters per second, mass flow rate is 4.5 kilograms per second. Area at exit equal to 3.5 into 10 power minus 3 meter square. We take example number 4. In a gas turbine installation, air is heated inside a heat exchanger up to 750 degrees Celsius from ambient temperature of 27 degrees Celsius. The hot air then enters the gas turbine with a velocity of 50 meters per second and leaves at 600 degrees Celsius. After leaving the turbine, enters a nozzle at 60 meters per second velocity and leaves the nozzle at a temperature of 500 degrees Celsius. For unit mass flow rate of the air, determine the following, assuming adiabatic expansion in the turbine and nozzle. 1. Heat transfer to the air in heat exchanger. 2. Power output of the turbine. 3. Velocity at the exit of the nozzle. You take Cp of the air equal to 1.005 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And this is from November 2018 question paper. And this is the arrangement. First, we have a heat exchanger. The air from atmosphere enters the heat exchanger where it is heated from 27 degrees Celsius to 750 degrees Celsius. Then hot air goes to the turbine. It is expanded here and the work is produced. The gas leaves at 600 degrees Celsius with a velocity of 60 meters per second and then it flows through a nozzle. In the nozzle, the velocity is increased and the fluid is leaving with 500 degrees Celsius. Now, we have to apply the steady flow energy equation for heat exchanger, gas turbine and nozzle and calculate the various parameters. First, the heat transfer to the air in the heat exchanger. So, Q12 equal to MCP into delta T. For a heat exchanger, heat transfer equal to MCP into delta T. So, MCP into T2 minus T1. So, M equal to 1 kilogram, Cp equal to 1.005. T2 is 750 degrees Celsius, T1 is 27 degrees Celsius. So, substituting the heat transfer in the heat exchanger is 726.6 kilojoules per second. And the power output of the turbine. So, we are given velocity and the enthalpy. So, W23 equal to M into 2Cp into T2 minus T3 plus V2 square by minus V3 square by 2. Actually, this is 2 into H2 minus H3. So H2 equal to Cp into T2 and H3 equal to Cp into T3. So substitute numerical value is M into 2 into Cp is 1005. So 1005 joules per kilogram Kelvin into 750 minus 600 plus 50 square minus 60 square divided by 2. And solving, the work done is 150,200 joules per second or 150.2 kilowatt. And exit velocity of the nozzle, V4 equal to square root of V3 square plus 2 Cp into T2 minus T3 minus T4. And substituting V3 equal to 60 square plus 2 into 1005 into 600 minus 50, this equal to 452.3 meters per second. So the answer to the problem, heat transfer to the air in heat exchanger is 726.6 kilojoules per kilogram. Power output of the turbine is 150.2 kilojoules per kg. And the velocity of the nozzle at the exit, velocity of the fluid at the exit of the nozzle is 452.3 meters per second. And example number 5, this is from anonymous question paper May 2015. A turbine operating under steady flow conditions receives steam at the following state. Pressure 13.8 bar, specific volume 0.143 meter cube per kilogram, internal energy is 2590 kilojoules per kilogram, velocity is 30 meters per second. The state of the steam leaving the turbine, pressure 0.35 bar, specific volume 4.37 meter cube per kilogram, internal energy is 2360 kilojoules per kilogram, velocity is 90 meters per second. Heat is lost to the surrounding at the rate of 0.25 kilojoules per second. If the rate of steam flow is 0.38 kilograms per second, what is the power developed by the turbine? So write down the given data. So pressure P1 equal to 13.8 bar, P2 equal to 0.38 bar, V1 equal to 30 meters per second, velocity at the outlet V2 equal to 90 meters per second, U1 internal energy at the inlet is 2590 kilojoules per kilogram, U2 internal energy at the outlet equal to 2360 kilojoules per kilogram, specific volume at the inlet 0.143 meter cube per kilogram, specific volume at the outlet 4.37 meter cube per kilogram, and the heat transfer, there is a heat loss minus 0.25 kilojoules per second, and mass flow rate is 0.38 kilograms per second. Now we calculate the enthalpy of the steam, H1 equal to U1 plus P1 V1. So this is 2590 plus 13.8 into 100. So this is 13.8 is in bar. So into 100 to convert into kilopascal into 0.143 equal to 2787.34 kilojoules per kilogram, and H2 equal to U2 plus P2 V2 equal to 2360 plus 0.35 into 100 plus into 4.37. So P into V, pressure in the volume, this is 2512.95 kilojoules per kilogram. Now we write this steady flow energy equation, general form of the equation, and we rearrange, we'll get the elevation is not given here. So the term which is not given, the parameter which is not given, that may be dropped. So dropping Z1 and Z2 from the equation and rearranging, W equal to M into V1 square minus V2 square divided by 2 plus H1 minus H2 plus Q. So substituting numerical values, mass equal to 0.38, V1 equal to 30 square minus 90 square divided by 2. And the H1 minus H2, this is in kilojoules per kilogram, multiplying by 1000, that gives in joules per kilogram. So calculating, the work done by the turbine is 102.9 kilowatts. So use the calculator and calculate the value, this is 102.9 kilowatts. So the power developed by the turbine, the answer is, power developed by the turbine is 102.9 kilowatts. So we stop here, we solve the remaining problem in the next lecture. So these are all the reference books I used for preparing the lectures. You can also refer to it for additional information. And this is my address, you can write to me to my mail ID. I will answer all your queries. Thank you, we'll meet again.